You've planned your business attendant and recorded your messages. Now you're ready to set up call trees and test your business attendant. Watch and we'll show you how. For an overview of business attendant and how to plan, watch part one, Understand and Plan. To learn how to record and upload your messages, watch part two, Create Your Messages. You can find these videos at www.att.com/smbhowtovideos. A call tree is the message sequence and caller options for callers that reach your business attendant. You can set up two call trees, one for calls received during business hours and one for calls received after business hours. Let's begin. We'll start on the business attendant page. To learn how to log in and get to the business attendant page, watch the video Sign In and Access Your Phone Features. First, make sure business attendant is off. Next, set the time zone. This is important because business attendant will use this to play your business hours and after hours messages at the correct times. Now scroll to Setup Messages. During business hours is selected by default. In this example, we'll set up our business hours call tree. First, we'll choose the welcome message. We click Select, and from the list of WAV files, select our welcome message recording. We're building the business hours call tree, so we'll select our daytime welcome message. Next, we select the caller options message. Next, to select a caller message, we'll click Select, and then choose the file from the list. Now, we'll set up caller actions. Keypad numbers are shown on the left. By default, all numbers are set to Repeat Menu. For our example, we'll assign different actions to the first three numbers. Our caller options menu begins, for sales, tap 1. So for key 1, we'll choose Transfer to Number and enter the number for the sales team. Remember, you can enter any 10-digit number in the US or Canada, including a mobile number. Our next caller option is tap 2 to hear our business hours. So for key 2, we'll choose Play Message and Repeat Menu, and then choose our business hours message from the list. Our third caller option is to leave a message, tap 3. So for key 3, we'll choose Transfer to Voicemail. Our last caller option is to repeat this menu, tap any key. For the remaining keys, we'll leave the default. Our business hours call tree is now complete. To set up your second call tree, click the After Business Hours tab and follow the same steps, selecting the messages and actions you've planned for after hours calls. You must select a greeting for your after hours call tree. If you want the same greeting as for your business hours call tree, select the same recording. Finally, enter your business schedule. The schedule determines when business attendant uses your business hours call tree or your after hours call tree. Select your open and close times for each day of the week. Or, to enter the same hours for all days of the week, check Copy Monday's hours for all days. When you've finished, click Save. Your setup is done. It's important to test your setup before starting business attendant. Choose a time when you're unlikely to receive a lot of calls. When you're ready to start testing, go to the Business Attendant Settings tab and choose On. Test your setup by calling your business attendant number, listening to the messages, and tapping each key. If you need to make changes, simply log in and make the changes on the business attendant page. For more videos, go to www.att.com/smbhowtovideos. For step-by-step help, go to the support center at att.com/smallbizsupport.